As the nation continues to wrestle with the crisis that is violence against women, a new battleground is emerging: tech terror. Just this week, a man was charged with domestic violence offences over tracking devices found in a woman's car in Sydney. But help is at hand thanks to these spyware superstars.
So we look inside the car, in the boot, under the wheel arches, under the bonnet.
Yep.
Steve Wilson has spent his entire working life trying to protect women from violent men. First, as a police officer, and now by ridding victim survivors' homes of the hidden devices their exes use to stalk and terrorise them.
An AirTag.
It's an Apple AirTag. And one of the team found 8 of these on one car, all numbered, categorised to where he had them.
8. 8.
Why is a car such a target?
Sometimes he may not know where she's living.
Yeah.
She may be in emergency accommodation, she may be in a refuge. It's just the control. He wants to know where the victim is.
Yeah.
And this is the easiest way to do it.
And cars are just the beginning.
So in a room like this, you'd look through the vents because we've found that they would put cameras through there. We've found one house that had 6 iPhones there filming through vents.
You can't even see this, though, like when that's just like that.
We can pick them up through scanning equipment.
From magnetic trackers to hidden cameras, listening devices, malware on phones and laptops, Steve's team finds it all in every single room.
A number of our team members have actually gone to homes with smart fridges and found perpetrators using that app to post messages on the whiteboard of the fridge, calling her names, you're never going to see the kids again, I'm going to self-harm.
There's no escape.
No, there's no escape.
No escape and nowhere to feel safe. Even teddy bears can be weaponized.
No way. So they would have just, like, opened that up,
yeah,
tucked that in there.
Here.
What?
Yep. A very small camera sitting inside of the Lego build.
It's so tiny, you wouldn't even know.
Yeah, something that appears to be a connectable, small listening device.
What?
Yeah.
That's a recorder.
That's a recorder, yeah.
They're going to put it in here. Imagine what they're doing.
Correct.
In their partner's room.
We had one perpetrator. He was a doctor. He would come through the manhole at night. He would film her in her bed. He would send her text messages and say, I see you're still wearing those same pyjamas I got you for anniversary 5 years ago.
Over 12 years, Steve estimates he's worked with 20 to 30,000 women. He says he finds monitoring devices at more than 90%. Of homes.
I don't think there's enough understanding in the community about how dangerous this sort of behaviour is. It's a red flag to intimate partner homicide and serious assaults.
Demand for his services is so high. Steve says he could double his team of 20 and it still wouldn't be enough.
We get more people when there's more tragedies. So we notice that recently we seem to get a lot more people coming to us through services or privately wanting assistance. They're more worried now seeing what's happening to other women that they're going to end up in the same way. They don't want to leave their bedrooms, some of them. They're so scared.
Matisse Price is one of Steve's employees. She knows firsthand how threatening a perpetrator can be.
A couple of weeks ago, I was sitting in a woman's kitchen going through her phone, removing the perpetrator's access, and she heard his car pull up, and I take my lanyard off so there's nothing to identify me. And he came into the kitchen and sort of just looked like we were having coffee, and he sort of had a look and then obviously wasn't suspicious. Used the bathroom and then left.
Matisse uses the same safety equipment her company arms vulnerable women with once they've cleared their homes of malicious tech.
I do wear a Duracell alarm everywhere I go, and it has given me a lot of that power back. I know that if I'm in trouble, I can press that alarm and the police will be there.
It's a phone and a camera. That sends GPS audio and video within 5 to 10 metres of where you are.
Jeez.
So that one has its own SIM card and goes direct to a monitoring centre.
For Matisse and Steve, seeing their clients finally at peace is what keeps them in the job.
When I find a tracker and am able to remove that and call the police and get them down, and the woman is so grateful that we're able to get rid of that, it's so empowering to stop that violence and stop that way that they are perpetrating that family violence.
What do the women say to you?
Thank you. Thank you. I would like to think that what we're doing is showing people that there is life after this horrible abuse and that someone's actually there again to listen to them.
What's really sobering about that report, even more so, is that if we actually played every single story that Steve had, that would probably be a 2-hour special over his career, what he has found, the women that he has helped. I mean, you think about smart homes now and how these are being weaponized. He had a story of one particular family who the perpetrator was controlling the fences of their house and locking the kids in, so therefore the mum couldn't take the kids to school, and then is like contacting the authorities being like, she's doing a bad job, she's not even taking them to school.
Oh, wow.
So that is the kind of insidious level that this is at, as well as all of the physical devices that you see that have probably already been planted there when they're still living in the home, before they've been kicked out or however they've been separated.
Or maybe, like, perfectly innocent items when the relationship's going.
Yes.
It's the way they can be used then for a nefarious purpose. Like, this tech stuff, like, you know me, I hate all this
tech
stuff, but we always think about what the government might do, what companies might do. The thought that we could do this to each other, and then in that context, obviously, when you're talking about ex-partners, is a terrifying thought because it's so insidious.
And everything that you use as though it's like a modern convenience, like using air conditioner, like controlling your sound system, well, ramp it up to like freezing degrees and get something, a screamo song happening at 3 a.m.
Oh.
That's also another story.
Horrific.
Oh, my God.
It's a really important one.
Good one, Tunny.